Romanian Foreign Minister Teodor Meleșcanu was on a three-day visit to India for the celebration of 70 years of the bilateral diplomatic relations between India and Romania. In an exclusive conversation with India TV, the Foreign Minister recognized India as a strong promoter of the ideas of peace and security. Teodor expressed pleasure visiting India and listed India as one of its top priorities in context to developing relations with its neighbors.
Would you like to share some details of the main features of the context and the current state of India and Romania relationship?
Yeah, it's a pleasure to have this chance to pay a visit here in India. And I have to say that it was a very good and efficient year from the point of view of our bilateral relations. We had the privilege of having the visit of the Honorable Vice President of India, Mr. Naidu, who paid a visit to Bucharest. He met everybody there, the President, the Prime Minister, the Presidents of the two chambers. And it's also true that besides the fact that we are celebrating 70 years from the beginning of our bilateral relations, we are also celebrating 5 years of the strategic partnership with India. From this point of view, it was a very good year, and I think I will try to do my best in order to continue this this context between India and Romania. This year, 2018, it's a very important year for Romania as well. It's the year of the, we are celebrating 100 years from the reunion of the old territories in which Romanians were living. And during these 100 years, our policy was always to improve our relations with our neighbors and to have very good relations with countries with which we are sharing the same values and ideas and spirituality, and India is one of them. One of the top priorities of our government, in the Romanian government, is the development of our relations with countries like India, which is one of the most important international players at the international scene. And we are very happy to work on our strategic partnership, to develop our bilateral relations, but also to have an excellent cooperation at the international scale within the United Nations and other organizations. That's why it's a very good year for us. And I repeat, I'll do my best in order to try to push and develop our bilateral relations and our cooperation in international organizations.
Speaking further in the same context, Your Highness, what are your expectations from the official talks included the agenda in the whole visit?
I will have the opportunity to meet Madame Swaraj, my counterpart, and we will discuss first of all about the development of our bilateral relations. A lot of positive things have happened. From this point of view, I want to tell to your listeners, those who are following the broadcast of your television, that 450 Indian companies are now Romanian companies. They are present in our economy, covering very important fields like pharmaceuticals, metallurgy, agriculture, and also IT and tourism. It's a very good point of departure, and I have to recognize that on this occasion I will also try to get in touch with different companies and officials from India in order to see how could we increase and develop these relations. All in all, in the last years, the trade exchanges between Romania and India increased in a spectacular way. We are around, we are practically around $1 billion in our exchanges, and we hope it will continue. And one of the key issues we are working at is the opening of a direct flight from Bucharest to New Delhi through our company, national company, and we hope it will give a serious impetus to the business community, travels, and also tourists. Indians are traveling a lot, and we'll be very glad to offer this possibility for Romania as well.
What is the main context of the message you intend to convey about Romania and the prospects of the India-Romania relation?
Our prospects is the desire to develop this strategic partnership. Our proposal is to try to agree on a kind of schedule which will permit us to follow very closely the possibilities to develop these bilateral relations. And from this point of view, we hope very much that our bilateral relations will continue to improve. I want to say just one word. You should not perceive our relations with India as only trade and investment relations. It's also a connection very important from our point of view with the spirituality of India, the culture of India, and the development of our relations in the cultural field and in the fields of the universities from our countries, and education in general. It's one of the top priorities for you. It's a priority for us as well. This is our perspective, and we are very interested in continuing to do that. From the, let's say, international point of view, India is playing a very important role in the international arena, and we are counting very much on the values promoted and the spirituality promoted by India. We are working hard together. We have a lot of joint support for elections in different organizations. Romania is competing for the year 2019 to arrive at an election which will permit us to be a non-permanent member of the Security Council for the period 2020-2022. And we are also supporting the candidatures of India in different other organizations. We are highly appreciating the contribution of India at preserving peace and trying to contribute to the solution of different conflicts existing in the world. And at the same time, we are also very interested in having a solid relationship with India for direct relations between Asia and the European Union, the European continent. Interconnectivity is the world. And from our point of view, the strategy adopted by the European Union this year in September about interconnectivity will offer us a very good chance to develop these relations. We have a big harbor in Romania, Constanța. We can have direct connections which will permit the goods from India to come to Europe in the best possible way. From this point of view, I have also to recognize that India is a strong promoter of the ideas of peace and security and political solutions for all the conflicts. We have learned very much from different personalities which were born in India. I'm just mentioning two names, Rabindranath Tagore, everybody knows about him. Mahatma Gandhi is an image which had a very important influence on our society as well. And one of our most important writers and philosophers, Mircea Eliade, he spent a lot of time in India, and he managed, after he came back to Romania and later to the United States, he had a very serious influence on the philosopher and political scientist of the world. We are also counting very much on the fact that India is one of the countries which is fully respecting the provisions, the principles, and the provisions of the international law. And from our point of view, this is a very important contribution in a world in which things are not always very quiet. In your region, in the region of the Pacific, but also in the European region. That's why we are counting very much on a partnership between Romania and India.
My last question to you, Your Highness, is that would you like to share your views on the prospects of the India-Romania cooperation on global issues as well?
Yes, we are participating together in a lot of peace missions, peace building in the framework of the United Nations. Afghanistan is one example, but there are a lot of other examples. And at the same time, we are working together on very peculiar issues and very important issues for both of our countries. And one of them is the fight against terrorism in the world. There is an Indian initiative on this issue, adopting an international convention for prohibiting terrorism and punishing those who are using this instrument in international relations. We are also supporting each other on all our initiatives, and we are very confident that the contribution of India and Romania, to a smaller extent of course, to the extent of our proportion, will contribute to a world which will be safer, more integrated, in which multilateralism and free economy, free trade, will be one of the important instruments of our development of the international society at the whole.
Thank you so much for your time, Your Highness.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
For India TV Digital, Surbhi Sharma's report.